how's it going, guys? This is Justin, aka Fizzier Fanatic, back with another badass fragrance review. And this time we are doing it on none other than Fantomas by the House of Nasamato.
Fantomas
was just released.
Fantomas.
Perfumer behind this is Alessandro Gualtieri. This is his newest edition. So I guess the story behind this is it's supposedly about a French crime thriller, and this is supposed to be a supervillain named Fantomas. That's what some of the people out there are speculating, and it makes kind of perfect sense. As far as the bottle itself goes, as you can see, the only real difference between this and the other ones still has that wood top, as you can see, but then it is reflective, which I am not a personal fan of this reflective material. It's already starting to flake and it looks pretty cheap. So I'm not a fan of that. But yes, as you can see, this has gotten some really good use to it, and I'm gonna tell you why here in a second. So what do I get from this? As we all know, there are no note breakdowns. From Alessandro Gualtieri, he says, hey, good luck with this. So what do you get from this? It's very soft. It's a very soft fragrance. It's very easy to wear. It's almost has like a chewiness quality to it, like Laffy Taffy almost. Definitely a fruity version, like Laffy Taffy, like if you were to, yeah, like banana Laffy Taffy, strawberry, raspberry Laffy Taffy. If you were to put all those together and chew it up and then breathe into somebody's face, this is what you get. That's, I mean, I'm joking. I mean, that's, I mean, it's not that like that really, but okay, well, it kind of is. But we're gonna waste the spray. Boom, great atomizer. As always. I really do enjoy this fragrance. It is a extrait de parfum, which is the highest level of perfume concentrate you can get. But as Sebastian, another reviewer out there, had said recently, that this is a, doesn't seem like it. It seems like a dulled down version, like a just a basically a de parfum. And I agree with that 100%. As you can see, it has gotten a lot of use. I just got this. I find myself reapplying this throughout the day because it's, it really becomes a skin scent after maybe about an hour, and it's really hard to find. And that's kind of disappointing, considering the House of Nasamato usually has some pretty hard hitters. Silver Musk, you know, that's a skin scent after a while as well. But yes, this was a blind buy. I just bought this because I was expecting a little something different. I was expecting something a little bit more challenging, a little bit more right up in your face. Yeah, I'm still smelling it in the air, obviously. There is a certain aluminum spaceship metallic quality to it. Like a cleanliness, a sterile cleanliness to it. Almost like a, like if you were to clean up a crime scene and whatnot, but still have that specific undertone where you can still smell that something bad has happened, like the sense of an aura of something bad that had just happened. Not necessarily like murder or anything like that, but whatever your interpretation story in your mind tells you with this. A reviewer out there had mentioned that this is an awful lot like the original Bat. Now, while we're talking about that, I do want to do a side-by-side comparison with this, because the Sebastian, shout out, go check out his page. I'm sure you guys already know who that is. Look good, feel, look great, smell good, I believe it is, something like that, yes. I should know this by now. But anyways, he said that this reminded him a lot of the original Bat by Zoologist. Now, he was unable to do a side-by-side because the Zoologist Bat was discontinued, I mean, still is. However, I happen to have an original bat from zoologists that I am very stingy with. And I've already done a side-by-side comparison with these two just to essentially rule out the similarities. The only similarities with these two fragrances that I get are, this is heavy on the soil accord. That's what it smells like, damp earth, dirt. It's beautiful. This was probably one of my favorite scents of all time as well, the original bat, but then the reformulation just came out and that is absolute shit. That was so disappointing, still is. That is very, very, very disappointing. And so I don't know why Victor didn't buy the formula once she opened it up, but who knows, maybe somebody else will get it and do something cool with it. But anyways, yes, this is heavy on the soil accord. You can definitely smell like the rotten fruit, you know, very cavernous and whatnot. So I mean, for those reasons, this is phenomenal. However, I don't really feel that there's a resemblance to these. If I were to say there is a resemblance, would be the slight soft fruitiness to it, but this is definitely a modernized or maybe synthesized fruit notes. Like I said, it's very chewy, very Laffy Taffy-ish. It doesn't really fit with the name, if you ask me. Phantomos sounds dark, it sounds more mysterious and whatnot. This is pretty doable. This, anybody could wear this. This is definitely, can go both sides. This is not leaning one way or another. You know, this is definitely 100% a unisex fragrance. But the, yeah, so I hope you guys like what you saw today. If you have any questions, please drop them in the comment box below. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. I always enjoy sharing these videos and sharing what my thoughts are with these. But anyways, I got this from the website, 30 ml. It is about, you know, give or take about $200. Might as well just round up. So $200 for the 30 mil. And I would give this out of a 1 to 10, 10 being the best, I would give this a solid 5 out of 10. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Get back at you.